his help. Today, we're going to just do like a daily stretching routine that you can do in the morning, in the evening, and it's all going to be on the floor, so just find a nice comfy spot somewhere. You only just need a little bit of space, tiny space, and come and join me. I'm actually going to just start today just sitting as well, just because I already am sitting. And just, we don't need any equipment or anything either, so just shake out the hands a little bit. Up the shoulder and bringing them back. Okay, so do that again. Roll the shoulders up and back. You can sit like this if you like, or if you want legs out, whatever feels right for you. Roll the shoulders up and back, or even just sit on a pillow. Doesn't matter. Okay, shoulders to the back. Roll them up and bring them forward. Just try to calm your breathing a little bit as well. Roll the shoulders back and forward, big circles, and back again. Roll them back and forward. Okay, shake the hands out again. Okay, just now shoulders, just lift them up, so squeeze them towards your ears, and then just let them go down, push them down. That was a nice slow one. I actually like to do the faster one, so let's try that, okay? So we squeeze it up, and we go. Like a release of stress. Okay, you squeeze it up, scrunch it up, and then just go. Yeah, it's nice to do that. Shake it out. Okay, so we're just going to go the head now. So you're just going to make your head just tilt towards your right shoulder. So just let it go and close your eyes if you like. But as you do this, just make sure that your left shoulder is sort of pushing down towards the floor. You don't want to be up here doing that, okay? So keep it down and just feel like a little bit of stretch in the side of your neck. Just relax. And then bring it back up to the center. Okay, so we're going to the other side now, so to the left side. Thumbs towards the back wall. Inhale. And then exhale, thumbs forward. Do that again. Thumbs to the back wall. Inhale. And shoulders again, little shoulder roll. I'm going to reach the arms to the front, thumbs are facing up now, reaching up, and then coming down, as we did before, so thumbs to the front. Do it again, reaching up, inhale, exhale, good. Okay, I think my legs are a bit tired of sitting in this position. We're going to change that a little bit. Okay, so one leg goes out to the side. Get nice and comfy. Like if you're finding this a little bit hard on the floor, you're finding, oh, that's a little bit hard to sit like this, it might be an idea to grab a pillow and just sit on a pillow. Sometimes that's a lot easier for people. Just do what's right for you. Okay, so I have one leg out to the side. If this is too hard for you out here, remember just you can always just go there. That's fine. All right, always just do what is the right thing. So we're going to go here, out to the side. I'm feeling a little bit of a stretch in my inner thigh just there. So if you're already really flexible, you probably won't, but anyway, I'm going to grab my fingers here, push up nice and tall. And as I'm going tall here, I'm feeling that stretch. I'm feeling this in here. So I am just going to stay here. But other people will go, oh, that's too easy. So I'll just show you a little bit. You can always just lean forward into that like this. Or if you can go further than that, my offside is not here with me. She's very flexible. She would go forward and she would put her hands here and would go right down towards the floor. But that's not me. But just do the right thing for you. Okay, flex the foot. Take a breath. Breathe out. And now point that toe. Stay here for a little bit. Okay, I'm going to keep my leg out to the side. I'm going to bend that knee a little bit. Okay, I'm not going to push it down flat. I'm going to bend it a little bit. I'm going to reach towards it and I'm going to go over. Now, we did that curve before. This time we're doing a few different stretches thrown in here. Now, you can keep that leg bent. Now, I'm showing you different levels. You can keep it bent, or if you're more flexible, you can straighten the leg. Okay, but still keep that nice curve there. You don't want this arm here. Reaching up and over, little C curve in the arm, and chest is open. So not collapsing in like this. But you can keep that bend. You could even be here, and that's fine, okay? But if you're more flexible, you could stretch down. Keep it. Excellent. And we're going to come back up to the center, and then we're going to just throw in a little Pilates one. Why not? Okay, so what we're going to do, because we're in this position anyway, hopefully you've got a mat under your feet, hand comes down, and I'm going to go up on that knee, and I'm pointing that toe over there, and I'm going to go curving the other way. Pilates, curve, over, and coming back down. Okay, oh, I'm feeling my hips are stretching out a bit here. Hopefully yours are too. We're going to go to the other side. So put the other leg out. Now remember, as I said, if that's a bit hard for you to be there, just bring the leg further forward, and that's still fine. Okay, I'm just going to bring it out to where it's about right for me. I'm feeling that a little bit. You just feel a little bit of tension there on the inner thigh. I'm going to put my hands behind me and really push myself up so I'm nice and tall, sitting up tall. Don't want to be scrunched over. If you scrunched over, you might need to go further forward here. Ah, it's more comfortable to sit straight. So over here. If you want a little lean forward, if you want big lean forward and crawling forward, I'm not doing that. But feel free to. So feel that stretch on the inner thigh. Stay up nice and tall. Yeah. chest, C curve. Or straighten it out, grab hold of the toes if you like, if you can. Don't feel pressured that you have to do anything. You can stop at any time. Feeling it down the side here. And gonna come back up. And then we do that, the one on the other side. Remember kind of coming up on the knee? I'm gonna bring that leg was forward here, so I'm gonna bring it to the side in line with my body. Oops, well that was my hip. Told you it does stuff with the hip. Hear that click? Okay, reaching up and over, really feeling the structure down my hip here and pointing my toe. So I'm doing lots of stretches here. I'm putting a fair bit of weight on this arm here, as well the one on the floor. And keeping the chest open. And coming back down. Okay. Good O. Let's just do this little butterfly one. Okay. Grab hold of the ankles if you like, or the toes if you like. Alright, so. Or if hard, here. If really hard, here. And on a pillow. Okay, so just what's right for you. I'm going to grab hold of my toes and have my feet in fairly close, so like that. And to make it a little bit harder, if you wish, grab hold of the ankles and then push down with your elbows. Feeling it in here, inner thighs. So sort of eye gaze should be sort of about a meter or two ahead of you, but looking sort of down here. So we're sort of keeping our spine in line. Some of these things. Positive affirmations, always good. Okay, coming down, actually I think, yes, I'll go this way. Yeah. I'm just going to roll down onto the mat. Just get down however, which way works for you, okay? Just sit nice and comfy. If you haven't got a mat on the floor somewhere, hopefully something nice and comfy is underneath you. It's just a towel. Shake out the legs a little bit. I'm just going to start with a whole body long stretch, okay? I like to start with this one sometimes. Stretching out, really feeling it through my tummy and pointing my toes, stretching my fingers, pulling them apart, making yourself 2 inches taller today. And then just relax. Okay, do that again. So everything's just sort of floppy at the moment. And now we go, big stretch. Make ourselves longer, taller, pointing the toes, stretching the arms out, really feeling that in your tummy and your core. And then just relax. Okay, so just do a couple. Gonna do some more. Of course we're gonna do some more. Put one leg in. Just doing stretches, but we do a tiny little bit of hip mobility as well while we're lying here. So just tuck that in. As close as you can, keep this one nice and straight. So we're stretching in the front of the leg here, we're sort of stretching into this leg, into the hips. So lying back and relaxing. From here, I'm just going to bend the other leg. Okay, stretch this one up, hamstring stretch. So just flex the foot, don't go straight into it, just sort of ease your way into it, particularly if you're not warm, if it's early in the morning. You know, don't go straight in. Just going to go here, flex the foot. I'm just going to take it a bit easier first. can grab behind if you like. The legs should be straight, but not locked down, okay? So fairly straight. And we should feel something down here. We should never be hurting. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a yoga sort of beginner style hamstring stretch here. Just a general fitness one. Doesn't have to be claimed by yoga or anybody, just a thing we do. And then we're going to do a Pilates one. Ah, what's a Pilates one? Ah, point the toe. Lift the shoulders up. Grab it a little bit higher. So, level one is just there. Okay, when we're doing the Pilates one. But if you want to work a little bit harder and you're strong in the hips, you've got to be strong in those hips, you straighten that leg out. And then, if you're feeling okay, you lift it. Okay, so just showing you a different version. You can grab it up here, try to pull it in more. But you don't have to do that, remember? You can always just be here. That's fine too. Because that's more beginner level here, yeah? Just giving you a few options. Okay, so I'm going to come back down. And then I'm going to stretch the outer side of my thigh. And to do that, I'm going to flex this foot. So as if I'm doing a hamstring one, this leg is bent. This one is coming across to the other side. What I'm going to do actually is put both my hands out. The hand is the opposite hand to this leg, okay? The one you're going to grab on the outside of the thigh and try to bring it across to this wall away. Now what you've got to do, what you've got to be careful of is you don't sort of go like this, okay? This knee here, the bent one, stays up facing the ceiling. So if you're not super, well, not that I'm super flexible, but if you're not very flexible, you might be down here, and that's fine too. You'll still get that stretching here, and that outside of your thigh. But you might need to move that leg further down. Okay. I'm going to go about there. That's where it's about right for me. And I'm feeling it down here. I don't often see many people at the gym doing this one. I like it. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to cross that leg and then we're going to hands through the middle. Here, did we already do this? I think I already did this, didn't I? I can't even remember. It doesn't matter. We're just going to do this one. Hands through the middle. Sometimes I lose track of what I'm doing, but it doesn't hurt to do things twice. Sometimes it's actually really good to do that. I think I did do it twice. Just relax into it. So this one's actually working, stretching into your glutes, onto your butt, okay? Just relaxing. It's too easy. You come here, lie back. I'd like to stay here. That works for me. I'm feeling it. Okay. So I'm going to bring that leg down. And I'm going to work through all those stretches on the other leg. So this leg is now straight. Okay, that one's a straight leg. This one comes up to my chest. So just remember we started lying on the ground, so make sure it's your other leg now. We're going to roll the ankle a little bit. And then roll it the other way. It doesn't come in rolls. As you do it, you might feel like, oh yeah, I can bring that in a bit more. You can probably bring it in a little bit closer to your chest. If you can, that's good. Just as long as it feels okay. Bend this leg, and then that leg's going out. So we do a hamstring stretch now. Remember, ease into it as well if you're not warm already. So don't go straight into pulling it in, just ease in. And keeping that leg bent as well is always it's good for you. It's supporting your back better than having it straight. So, you know, when we did straight on the other side, only do that if you've got it, you know, if your back's feeling all right as well. I should have said that before, but anyway, it doesn't matter. You'll be right. So I'm going to pull that in a little bit more now and point my toe. And then I'm going to flex my foot. Just relaxing into it. If that's too hard as well to do this, you know, sometimes you can just use your tights, use your shorts, whatever you've got on to help pull it in. Grab a towel, stick a towel around, pull it around the back. Okay, so we're going to do our Pilates one, aren't we? So we're going to point the toe and we're going to lift the shoulders up. Now remember, stay here if you want. If that's comfy for you, if that's enough, do that. Okay, just stay there. If you want to work the harder level, the leg goes out and you try to keep it off the floor. So we're actually really engaging these muscles in here. You've got to squeeze your butt, squeeze the thigh as well as we do that. And then lift your shoulders across. But remember, you don't have to do it. Three, two, and one. Okay, I'm going to bring that leg back. It's bent now. So we're going to do the one on the out, working the outside of the thigh. So hands go down to the side first. Okay, opposite hand to that leg goes across to the outside of the leg, and we're going to bring that across. Knee here on this one stays up. So it goes across. You should start to feel that down the outside of the thigh. My leg gets up towards the ceiling. Keep the shoulders down towards the floor. And if you can't reach here, that's fine. You just go there and go wherever you can. You know, just do what's right for you. And breathe. Always breathe. Always breathe. Coming back up, crossing that leg across. Hands go through the middle, through the window. And lying back down, so doing the glute stretch on the other side. So if you feel like that's too easy, remember, go here, or to make it harder again, flex the foot and bring it in closer to your groin, and that will make it harder. But I am staying here. This is enough. Okay. So I'm going to bring that leg up out. Just do a little bit of hip mobility. Just a little bit. Okay, so don't be worried. Just a little bit of Pilates things. We're just going to bring one knee up here. So this leg is just on the ground. This one, I'm just bringing it up so my knee is over my hip, okay? I'm just going to, as if I've got a pencil attached to the end of my knee here, and I'm going to draw a little circle on the ceiling. Okay, so hands are down here, and the lower spine in here is just pushing a little bit into the mat, so you're imprinting the lower spine into the mat, okay? So keeping it nice and firm. We just do a little circle. So you do a little circle round, as if you're doing a painting a circle on the ceiling, and then we're going to stop. Okay, so I'm bringing that up towards my head first, circling it up and around, and then I'm stopping. As I'm doing that, I've got to try to keep this leg still. So circle, and then we stop. I'm really focusing on keeping this leg still. Should we go the other way, same leg? So other way, doing the circle the other way. So I'm going down first and around. This hip really wants to move. So you've got to work with your body to try to keep it still. As we're circling, just be a little tiny circle, that's fine. Doesn't matter. We'll do just one more. We're just doing three. Around. And back and up. Good. The other side. Good work. Alright, so that leg's down, this one's up, okay? Pencil on the end. I'm going to do a little circle, so I'm going to bring up towards my head first and around nice and slowly, bring it back, and then we stop. I've got to focus on this one, keeping it still, trying not to let my pelvis and my hips move this leg. So I'm going to do the third one around. I'm doing a big circle with that one on the ceiling, and then we're going to go the other way. Okay, so down first, and around. I know it's not a stretch, but it's a good mobility one. It really, really is. Down and around. Good to keep that mobility in the hips. Unless we're doing lots of salsa dancing, we're not really doing too much with our hips at the moment. I love salsa dancing. Okay, so that was three each way. So now we just have a big stretch out. Well done. Big stretch. We'll just do a couple more stretches. Up a little bit. Actually, we might just do a thigh stretch while we're here. That's nice. Just lie down on your side. And just make sure my legs are in line here, and then I'm going to grab hold of my foot and just do a thigh stretch. So if you're not warm, don't be too mean to yourself here. You know, just take it a bit easy, let the legs stay out. But if you've warmed from doing other things, you can pull that foot in towards your bottom a little bit more. And you want to work a little bit harder, you get that hip and you push that hip forward. The upper hip. And we're going to do the other side. And for you to do that, easy peasy, just roll over, okay? But I'm going to do the instructor thing and look at my class. And go like that. Okay, and we're going to do that on the other side. So grab hold of your foot, keep the knees fairly close together as you do it, and then pull it in towards your bottom. Push the hip forward, just a little bit forward, to make it harder if you wish. Just try to get most of the major area stretched here. Okay, just going to get that, put that leg down, and I'm going to roll over, and so are you. I'm going to go back with my head down this way. You don't have to do this. My hips are cracking like crazy. You must be having a good time. Alright, so I'm going to go on my knees for a second. I'm going to do a hip stretch by coming forward, go step forward. Going to put a bit of weight on here. Now, some people might find that it's a little bit hard on the back knee, so you might need to get a towel or something to put it under that knee. Or if you've got a mat, I'll just show you. If you've got a mat, it's a good thing to just go like this. Good old thing I used to do in some of my classes. Put your knees here and then step forward. Ah, oh, that's much nicer. So you can just rest here, but then your hip on the other side, which you can't see. I just did the wrong leg, didn't I? Anyway, push that hip towards the floor. So we're really trying to stretch through here. You'll see when I show you in a bit. You'll be fine. I like to do this. Like, need a cup of tea, don't I? And coming up. Good. And then we're going to do the other side. So I'm going to go here. Step forward with my other leg. Oh, goodness me. I'm just going to smack cracks today. So you're here. Now, if that's enough for you, you stay there. If you want to work a little bit harder, just watch your knee doesn't come over your toes, okay? We want that to be up fairly straight. You can come forward here, or you can even come here, okay? I could have showed you on the other side, but just you just don't want this leg to be like that, okay? That's not what you want, okay? So you've got to have to make sure it's fairly far forward. And this is fine, too. So you should be feeling something in here, hopefully. inside leg. Okay, coming back. Good. So I'm going to just push my mat out again. So now we shall do a calf stretch. So hands are here, knees shoulder width apart, pushing one toe, one foot into the ground, toe tucked in and heel back. Keeping your back fairly straight. I'm just like this, that's annoying. So keep your back straight. Just really push that heel back. And then we're going to go the other leg. We're not staying on that for too long. Not really staying on anything for too long today. It's only a bit of an all over thing. This is good for me. I didn't work out before. And to do all these stretches actually is really helping me. So hopefully it's helping you guys as well. It's good for me. Stretches everything out. And then we're going to go just here and sit back on our heels and do a little bit of a child's pose. That might be enough for you, just like that. That might be fine, and that's okay. If you're a little bit more flexible and more used to it, you might want to put your hands right out the front here and just stretch down like this. Just rest your head down, or sometimes people like this one. You won't stay here for long though. That's a nice one too, just a little bit of a rest. Rolling up nice and slowly. Won't stay there for long because I know a lot of people don't like to be here. Okay, just going to finish off with a twist. Coming back down onto the floor again. And because it's just really nice to finish with a twist. And your body's already a little bit warm, so it's a good one to finish off with. So I'm just rolling back. You can just come back down as you like. I'm just going to my hands out to the side. Knees come up, I'm imprinting my spine here. I'm just going to let the knees go to one side. I'm actually going to put my feet down on the ground. I quite like this, a little bit more support to be my feet down on the ground, and then just let them go across. So head can be facing the same way as the knees, but you get a little bit more twist if you look up. Or you can look away, it's even a little bit more twist in the upper body. Hand doesn't have to be forward. I'm guessing it's probably not on camera. That's fine. It can be here, wherever you like. I'm just sort of doing that. That can be wherever you like. It can be here. Feel a little bit of stretch through there, through the lower spine. And relax. Take a few deep breaths. Slowly bring those knees up, and then you're just going to roll them to the other side. Just let them roll over. Once again, head eye gaze can be towards where those knees have fallen. They can be straight up towards the ceiling, or you can look away. Okay, we're going to look away this time. Adds a little bit more stretch to the upper body. Let's do what's right for you. Close your eyes if you like. Just relax the shoulders. Take some deep breaths. Doing really well. It's good to look after yourself. Thank you. massage in your back. And then just lie the legs down. Let's have a little rest. Just going to lie down, do a little bit of a shavasana. Or maybe not. Maybe not today. I think maybe we just do a little stretch. We'll lie down here for a minute, just breathe and relax. Breathing out. You shouldn't be looking to the side. Reaching up with the arms and then just relax. Okay, so thanks for joining me. I think I'll just lie here because this is very comfortable for me. I'm quite relaxed now. Hopefully you feel relaxed too. And maybe for a little while and just take some deep breaths and just enjoy a bit of peace and quiet for a while. So I'll see you next time.